remarks.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and thank you for scheduling this important hearing. And like Alaska, Washington has a lot of related issues, and so this is a hearing of great importance to our state as well. I'd like to extend a warm welcome to all the witnesses today, and thank you for being here, Ms. Kimball. And also want to say hello to Dr. John Vidal, who's here from Washington State. He is the Washington State Seismologist Director at the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network and professor at the University of Washington. And these are people we count on all of the time, and so we so appreciate them being here. It's a great opportunity this morning to talk about the importance of the USGS and the premier earth science agency and one of its most respected roles that are so important to us, producing nation's maps, monitoring our rivers, guiding our energy and mineral development, supporting the management of public lands, helping us respond to natural disasters such as floods, earthquakes, volcanoes, and landslides. And as a primary science agency for the Department of Interior, they play an incredible role in forming decision-making that the department has in many of its areas, and they also provide technical assistance to tribes and communities across the country. So these partnerships are particularly important in forming our decisions at the local level, and in many states, the USGS is the critical partner that it is in our state. And I'd like to take a few minutes just to highlight what that partnership means. First, the area of partnerships is to protect the public from natural disasters, and the USGS is the federal agency responsible for monitoring these natural hazards, such as volcanoes, earthquakes, and landslides. Washington, like Alaska, has its share of these, and we are so glad that they are an absolute partner in monitoring and responding to these. As many people know, Mount St. Helens erupted in 1980, one of the largest volcanic eruptions in U.S. history. And in fact, Washington State has six volcanoes, including Mount Rainier, which is considered the nation's most dangerous. Since 1998, the U.S. has partnered with Pierce County to operate a Lahar warning system to protect the lives and property that could occur in that eruption, which there's probably 80,000 people in the path of that potential eruption in Lahar. So, not that Mount St. Helens wasn't significant, but the population density around Mount Rainier is in a total another story. However, new monitoring science and warning systems are needed throughout the West, and that is why Chairman Murkowski and I are co-sponsoring the National Volcano Early Warning and Monitoring System to protect communities that are at these high-risk areas. And another significant hazard in Washington State is earthquakes, just like the chair said. And Dr. Vidal, there is a, who is here, is the state seismologist who's been working with USGS along the West Coast to develop an earthquake early warning system. So USGS studies show that earthquakes can occur in the next 50 years and are estimated that they could approach the intensity of the quake and tsunami that struck Japan in 2011 and particularly could affect major cities like Seattle. In fact, we are having the largest scale tsunami drill in 2 months from now, in the next 60 days, in the Northwest. That is going to be thousands of people participating and how to respond to that. That is why we continue to advocate for the earthquake early warning system, because it would save lives and billions of dollars, and why we also introduced the Tsunami Warning Education Act, which this bill passed the Senate last year, would require USGS to work with NOAA on a tsunami program. And Madam Chair, just for you, because I know you care so much about this, our work on the Commerce Committee and looking at this, there's so much that needs to be done with the mapping and then working with the local community that needs to be knitted together. People need to see the maps, what could potentially happen, then the community has to knit together a response. And that isn't, and all the agencies that are responsible for that need to work together. Finally, I want to mention the terrible tragedy of Oso that occurred in March of 2014, which caused 43 deaths. That mudslide was such a devastation, and we still feel the loss of life and thank so many of our first responders who responded to that. The USGS provided critical assistance in the search and rescue operation, including real-time monitoring to keep our first responders safe. A horrible tragedy. And yet, we couldn't even, without USGS, send the first responders into the area without their information and data about whether it was safe to go into the area. And so we were counting on them. Landslides cause over 24 fatalities and $1 to $2 billion a year across the country. So this is a significant issue. So I think better understanding these hazards and their impact and potential to helping save life and property is very important. So I'm pleased to hear that USGS is proposing to increase its work in this area. We need a national landslide mitigation strategy, more science, more monitoring to prevent these tragedies from occurring. And another area I just want to highlight is the USGS protects and restores wetlands, and Washington is one of home to some of the greatest rivers and estuaries, and so the Puget Sound and Columbia River are economic and critical lifeblood of our economy, so their work there is very important. And the USGS faced a number of institutional challenges in carrying out its mission with a budget of only $1.06 billion. The organization leverages its resources many times over. However, many areas such as the hazard and monitoring are severely underfunded. This is where I think good science really can help all of us move forward. Strategic investments are needed to advance new science and tools, and a number of programs and business practices need to be modernized and streamlined, and it is important that we have these programs. I know other our committees are talking a lot about drone and drone systems. These can provide some very critical tools and information, so we want to see that move forward so that these agencies can use these effectively. So again, so glad that we're having both panels today, and again, thank you for being here.